Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to 8thirsty.
Welcome, welcome.
We can't see, but what? Ah, the little chicky. What kind is it, Jess?
Well, I do believe this is a cochin, which I have been searching the world for 7 or 8 years. And I was just able to hatch my own little cochin. So it's very
cute.
Big.
Little wings.
Yeah, and look at the feathered feet.
What a cutie.
She or he is going to be very big.
Well, kids love baby chicks.
I love baby chicks.
You know what else kids love?
Tell me.
Playing fun games, learning things,
yeah.
And that's what we're doing this week, right?
Yes, we are.
So, Jessica, I have created for you a mini escape room. See how excited she is. That's very similar to my face maybe 5 days ago at the start of Philippians.
Maybe you did get me back.
Here is your first clue.
Okay.
I'm going to hold the chip.
Great. For Jess.
I've made it very easy.
So it says 2 on it. Is that right?
Open it.
Okay. The 10 virgins might have needed oil for lighting this.
Okay. So now your job is to look around this room. Everything is up on the higher level except for one thing.
Oh! I can see it.
What have you found?
I found a lamp.
A lamp.
Can I pull it?
Have you got a clue?
Sure.
Great. What does it say?
I like this escape room. I'm not feeling freaked out about it. It says lantern number 3.
No, don't worry about that. Just the inside is for you.
What a son asks for and doesn't get a scorpion.
So, they've got a little Bible reference on the bottom. If you're really stuck, you can open your Bible.
Well, let's open our Bible. Because why would it be, right? I may or may not know the answer.
What a son asks for and doesn't get a scorpion. We could have done this live and people could have answered.
Oh, yeah. Maybe we can do it.
Let's do a big one another time. This is a baby one.
Okay, but 11. If a son shall ask bread of any of you that is a father, will he give him a stone? So it's not bread.
No.
Or if he ask a fish, will he for a fish give him a serpent?
No.
Okay, keep reading.
Yeah.
Or if he shall ask an egg, will he offer him a scorpion?
Okay, so
are you going to lay an egg?
That would have been really beautiful timing. But so what are you going to look for?
I'm looking for an egg of some sort.
Okay.
Okay.
So.
Oh, I see an egg carton. Could this be it?
It may be it.
Woo!
Oh, she's found another clue.
Right. A liquid gift for baby Jesus.
Oh.
Ooh. Let's go to Matthew chapter 2. That's cool. Sam, this is great fun. I like this game.
I think you can guess that.
Do you want me to guess?
Yes.
Frankincense?
Then where would you find it?
Oh, in essential oil.
I've made it pretty easy if you look down.
Sam, this is great. This is fun. I almost fell off the chair. All right. We've gone to a lot of effort, Samantha. What Jesus took from Hades?
Oh. Ooh. Really did actually happen. Didn't it?
The key.
Uh-huh. Where would you find keys here?
Up there.
Oh. Ladies, she has found the final clue. Will she get to escape the room today?
Let's have a look. You're free! Congratulations!
You're free! You've
free,
been saved!
Free, I'm free at last. I thank God Almighty, I'm free at last.
Well,
that's great.
Well, that is what I used to do for my kids growing up. I used to make, not Christian because I wasn't a Christian then, but
okay.
I used to make little treasure hunts for them all around the house, all around the yard to go and find. I love doing it.
It's so fun.
And they loved it. Have your chicken back. We've got to read a Bible.
I win a chicken.
So, you know, it's easy to do.
That's great, Sam.
And it helps you to learn things in your Bible as well. And putting the little clue on there for them means, you know, they either get to use their memory, which is great, or they get to read the Bible more, which is double great.
That's awesome.
Well,
I wonder if you could do it in a public place.
100%.
Like a special,
yeah,
Those things that, I've forgotten what they're called. Is it called cache hunting?
Oh, geocaching.
Geocaching, you know, except you do it this way.
We went to Queen's Park in Maryborough yesterday. That is a beautiful park. Have you been there? Well, I'm going to make one for the park.
Great idea.
We'll invite you, maybe. Let's read the Bible. It's Colossians chapter 2.
Yes, it is. Luke this morning said to me, so we had a beautiful time last night with an amazing family. You know who you are. If you're watching today, you'll know. Sunday morning, Saturday night. Anyway, beautiful night. And Luke this morning, we were talking about the Bible. And he's like, Jess, I think my favorite chapter in the whole Bible is Colossians chapter 1. I was like, have you been watching my videos? He's like, what do you mean? And I press play from yesterday. And he's like, no way!
That's great.
It's like we're a perfect match.
Oh, we already knew.
So good.
That's great.
Colossians chapter 2.
You go when you're ready.
I will. For I would have ye... What?
Where are you?
Do you know it?
No, what?
Are you there?
Yeah. Okay. I don't think it says have, but carry on.
It was a late night last night. It's quite possible I didn't read it right. For I would that ye knew what great conflict I have for you, and for them at Laodicea, and for as many as have not seen my face in the flesh.
That their hearts might be comforted, being knit together in love, and unto all riches of the full assurance of understanding, to the acknowledgement of the mystery of God, and of the Father, and of Christ.
In whom are hid all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge.
And this I say, lest any man should beguile you with enticing words.
For though I be absent in the flesh, yet am I with you in the spirit, joying and beholding your order and the steadfast of your faith in Christ.
As ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him.
Rooted and built up in faith. Oh, hang on, I'm making that up.
It's all right.
Rooted and built up in him and established in the faith, as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ.
For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily.
And ye are complete in him, which is the head of all principality and power.
In whom also ye are circumcised with the circumcision made without hands, in putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ.
Buried with him in baptism, where also ye are risen with him through the faith of the operation of God, who hath raised him from the dead.
And you, being dead in your sins and the uncircumcision of your flesh, hath he quickened together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses.
Blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross.
And having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a shew of them openly, triumphing over them in it.
Let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink, or in respect of an holy day, or of the new, pardon me, of the new moon, or of the Sabbath days.
Which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of Christ.
Let no man beguile you of your reward in a voluntary humility and worshipping of angels, intruding into those things which he hath not seen, vainly puffed up by his fleshly mind.
And not holding the head, from which all the body by joints and bands, having nourishment, ministered and knit together, increaseth with the increase of God.
Wherefore, if ye be dead with Christ from the rudiments of the world, why, as though living in the world, are ye subject to ordinances?
Touch not, taste not, handle not.
Which all are to perish with the using, after the commandments and doctrines of men.
Which
of men?
Which things have indeed a shew of wisdom in will worship and humility and neglecting of the body, not in any honour to the satisfying of the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Oh. Colossians 2.
How so, about that beautiful image of being knit together?
Does it say that? Where?
Yeah,
there's so many cool things in there.
So many. Verse 2.
Verse 2.
That their hearts might be comforted being knit together.
And unto all riches of the full assurance of understanding. I think that's very
it's
cool.
Very deep. Just that verse.
Yeah, and the mystery comes in again.
Of God and of the Father and of Christ. That's three mysteries. I wonder if anyone knows them. We should do a study on them.
Oh, yeah. So it speaks about Laodicea in here.
Yes.
You know that Colossus was only 20 kilometers from Laodicea, just up the road.
That's very close.
Yeah. 200 kilometers east of Ephesus.
Right. Do you feel like drawing a map?
I'd love to draw a map. Maybe Jasper would love to draw a map. He's great at mapping.
He's very
mappery.
Good.
So these Judaizers are back again, aren't they? In verse 16, let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink or respect of an holy day.
Are you in verse 16, did you say?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they're also in 8.
So they just keep coming back saying, follow the law, follow the law, follow the law.
They're just spying out the liberty again.
Oh, spying out the liberty.
That's wrong.
There were also some people at this time who were practicing asceticism.
Oh, what is that?
That's where you just be very strict in denying yourself of things as a form of spiritual discipline. So,
like starving yourself of food.
Yeah, all of those things. But that, we know, doesn't make you any more holy. Doesn't get you any more saved.
It's like smashing yourself, as much as you can to, get the flesh to comply.
Yep.
But that's a work.
Yeah.
That's not at all biblical.
Yep. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ. This is still a very valid warning today.
True story. I wonder how many of us have got traditions that we've had to break out of or that we still need to break out of.
Man's ways are not God's ways. And this chapter is a lot of warning against false teachers.
Yep.
So it's a shame. It's a shame.
Verse 7. Read that for us.
Rooted and built up in him and established in the faith as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Yeah.
When you go to an incredible spot, like a creek or something. I remember Warburton down in Victoria.
Oh.
So beautiful. Or Warrandyte, Jumping Creek.
Yeah.
Like just these beautiful, special spots where it's freezing, by the way. So you have to if you want to go in, you've got to I can do this. Or in Tassie, where we went to Tassie.
Yeah.
Mole Creek.
Yeah.
All these special little places. You see a tree that's rooted next to a water source and how it
It flaps.
It flourishes. Because it's rooted and grounded in good soil.
Yep.
And it has that nourishment that's coming into it. And it's abounding with thanksgiving. I sometimes look at trees and go, wow, that's a joyful tree.
Well, this tree that I'm going to show you in Maryborough is, I'm not even going to tell you about it. I'm going to film it.
Okay.
Why don't we go there one day and film?
Great.
And that'll be talking about roots of trees.
Excellent. We'll totally hook that one up. That's a great idea.
Mm.
So in the natural, in the spiritual. God's always talking about natural things.
Oh, yeah.
And then showing, he talks about mother hens. And remember with that scripture where he says, I wish I could gather you my wings like a mother hen would gather her chicks. There's so many beautiful illustrations. So being rooted and built up in him is such a descriptive. He's the cornerstone, right?
Yeah.
No better way to be built up than with him.
And we get another reference to Jesus as God. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
And then ye are complete in him,
yeah,
which is the head of all principalities and powers. Take that,
yeah,
Satan.
That's right.
Oh, how about verse 15? What an incredible verse. Read it, Sam.
15?
Yeah.
Well, I wanted to read 17, so let's start at 15. And having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a shew of them openly, triumphing over them in it.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Let no man therefore judge you, etc., etc. Mm-hmm. But then in 17, which, hang on, I'll say it all. Let no man therefore judge you in meat or drink or in respect of an holy day or of the new moon or of the Sabbath days, which are a shadow of things to come.
Mm-hmm.
What it's do you think shadow. That means?
Well, it's a pattern.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, there are things in prophecy that tell us, that use the Sabbath days and the holy days, right, mm-hmm. to tell us what's coming in the future.
True.
But the body is of Christ.
But.
That is a great mystery.
It is a great mystery. Don't you love, you just took me through a mystery room.
Oh, a mystery room.
Well, I'd Let's like that Let's call it a
mystery room.
Better than...
Yeah,
escape.
A mystery room.
Yeah, it's a mystery. And there's so many beautiful revealed mysteries in here. I love that we get to unpack these, Sam.
Yeah. It's a great book, mate. The best book.
It's so much more exciting than just hearing a rah-rah message.
You're right. I've always loved reading, but this is a book that you can just keep going and going.
Going and going.
Going and going and going. And learning and learning.
All the time. So do you feel like Colossians 2 just followed on from Colossians 1?
Yeah.
It's funny how that happens. I wonder what Colossians 3 is going to say tomorrow.
We'll find out. Let's see what fun activity we've got.
Have a beautiful day.
Bye.